It's Becky. This year I was invited to Maker Secret Santa, where we each make each other personalized gifts. And the name I drew at random is the inimitable Colin Furze. Make Colin a truly American gift, something that transports him across the pond to right here in New York City. And now that Colin's been a food judge on British TV, what better way than to share a local culinary tradition, the sidewalk hot dog cart. So for Colin, I'm building a New York hot dog experience machine. Also, Stephanie and Ruth helped me come up with the idea. Let's go. I wanted to help Colin feel like he was really in New York City. So I went to some different spots in Manhattan to record some audio. Of course, I had to stop for a hot dog, traditionally topped with mustard and an onion sauce made with tomatoes. I found some hot dog robots online, but all they did was pick up the dog, never put toppings on, which is mostly what you see happening at a New York City hot dog cart. So I started my quest to build a toppings machine and figured it might as well look the part too.
I'm very excited to see what it looks like.
Now, mechanical engineering isn't usually my strongest subject, and I really didn't want to mess up this awesome idea. So I called on my friend Ruby Zoom for help. She helped design the mechanisms, and it was a blast working with her on this project. Please go check out her channel. The mustard squeezer and onion dumper are 3D printed and have servo motors controlling their movement. I put the NYC audio on a soundboard that's driving a pair of speakers, so Colin will hear the sounds of the street while the hot dog is being prepared. To further deck out the machine like a hot dog cart, I added an LED matrix display, some food stickers, and a small umbrella. Now, I know we were supposed to stick to a small materials budget for this project, but sponsored parts don't count, and this video is sponsored by Digi-Key. I was able to easily source all the electronics parts for this build, and they ship super fast. I put links to the bill of materials and tutorial for this project in the description. The LED matrix is made from three smaller panels, and the LEDs are dot stars. It has its own little microcontroller, so I didn't have to worry about integrating the LED animations with the motors or switches up top. The code is just easier that way. Fittingly enough, the umbrella that ended up being the right scale for this project is an American Girl doll umbrella. I fitted it with some blue and yellow fabric to make it look more like the ones on the hot dog carts. I used some iron-on t-shirt vinyl and my CNC vinyl cutter to make the graphics. Food art was inspired by the signs you see plastered all over the hot dog carts. I whipped up a big tile up in Illustrator and printed it on some sticky vinyl. The idea for the hot dog conveyance is simple: gravity. I built two cardboard prototypes to test out the spacing and pitch of the row of rollers. At the same time, I was testing the toppings mechanisms, starting with the mustard squeezer. I used bits of aluminum extrusion I had kicking around to make a simple gantry for the mustard. The squeezer has two motors, one to wiggle the bottle back and forth, and one to squeeze out the mustard. The onion sauce plopper has one motor that spins the sauce trough to dump out the sauce. Once I was satisfied with the cardboard prototype, I laser cut the final pieces out of quarter-inch acrylic over at my hackerspace. I used an open source box generator for the main edge joinery, and then used Illustrator to tweak the design and cut out holes everywhere I needed them. After applying my food art to some of the panels, I assembled the box and used methylene chloride to bond the acrylic seams. The electronics for this project are based around a motor driver board to control all three servos, hooked up to a microcontroller that is also reading the photoresistor to detect the hot dog, and also two manual control buttons for loading and unloading the mustard bottle. Power is shared between this main circuit and the soundboard controlling the audio, as well as the LED matrix and its dedicated microcontroller. I made some polymer clay pretzels to go with the experience, but by the time it was ready to ship to Colin, my studio was such a mess that I couldn't find them. They turned up when I cleaned up, so I'll put them on the second version of the machine I made to keep for myself.
Acceptable!
All that was left to do was to send Colin's gift to him in the UK. I included the mustard, onion sauce, UK power adapter, and some instructions. Head over to Colin's channel to watch him open it and try it out.
Okay, so I've received my Secret Santa package, and it's from... Thea Ulrich! Wait, hang on, isn't she the woman who glitter-bombed Mark Rober? I'm gonna need to put some safety glasses on for this.
Thea is a top-notch welder and circus person in Los Angeles, making all kinds of stuff on her channel. Be sure to head over there and subscribe. Oh man, I really dig this mantis blade.
I wonder what she made me. Oh, okay, I'm gonna open it. Okay. A card. All right, since you like motorcycles, LED programming, and crafts projects, I do like all of those things, I decided to combine all three. I made you a lighting sconce out of this vintage scrap motorcycle fuel tank. Oh, that sounds nice. Once plugged in, the middle button is the on-off switch. The other two buttons have some fun programmed options for you to explore. Enjoy. Heart, Thea. Okay, sounds great and straightforward enough. No glitter. Do you think I can take off my safety glasses? Thank you. Oh, wow. Oh, this is so nice. Ooh. Some plasma cut. Oh, I love a good USB cable. We know there's some stuff going on then there, huh? Wow, look at this intricate plasma cutting. Oh, this is so cool. Here, the cleat hangs here, yes. And then I see an Arduino. And whoa, two pixel matrices inside. Let's hang it on the wall and see what it does. I I see now why there's multiple rows of LEDs, why the matrices are useful, because the pattern is making it look like the wings of a butterfly. It's so awesome. Right. And then this button puts it in, I see, a static mode where it's not flapping. Color on the left, animation on the right. Wow, that's so awesome, I love it. Thank you so much, Thea. What an incredible gift. Maker Secret Santa was so much fun this year. Thanks so much for watching, and to Digi-Key for sponsoring this video. Check out all the Maker Secret Santa videos at the series, the link in the description. I'm also happy to announce that I'm taking my channel full-time. I left my corporate full-time job to pursue self-employment, publishing my own projects here on my channel, which is supported through ads, affiliate links, brand sponsorships, and direct support from viewers like you through Patreon and YouTube memberships. Thanks so much for your support that has allowed me to get here. See you next time.